With 27,000 tons of concrete in this structure, the contractors could have covered 25 acres, 4 inches deep, with the same amount of concrete. But they didn't. They poured it and their best structural efforts into a facility sure to change the dynamics of downtown Chattanooga. Covered with precast concrete panels that weigh from 800 to 1,000 pounds apiece, and topped with 70-foot tall glass spires, it sits amid thousands of trees, shrubs, and plants on the banks of the Tennessee River, connecting the city to its roots. Before Chattanooga was ever a city, though, Ross's Landing was a trading post and a commercial port for riverboats bound for the Mississippi. In the late 1970s, though, architecture students from the University of Tennessee put together an exhibit called Images of the City, suggesting the Chattanooga riverfront be anchored by an aquarium.
It caused a lot of interest at that time, but it was very subliminal. I mean, people didn't walk out of that exhibit, we got to build an aquarium. It just kind of planted a seed.
Later, in studies on saving the Walnut Street Bridge and riverfront development from the Chickamauga Dam to the Tennessee River Gorge, an aquarium was again suggested for Ross's Landing. When organizers went to Tennessee Governor Lamar Alexander to ask for funding support, he urged them to go for a world-class facility and gave them $3.5 million to do that. But the real boost for the aquarium came from Chattanooga millionaire Jack Lupton. He donated $14 million from his Lyndhurst Foundation and gave another $11 million from his personal finances. With this kind of private funding behind the project, it shifted to becoming completely funded by private and corporate donations. The public funds given by Governor Alexander and later from Governor Ned McWhorter were put into the public park and plaza around the aquarium. World-class architect Peter Chermayoff of Boston was hired to add Chattanooga to his list of cities for which he had designed an aquarium. Working with the Larson Company of Tucson, Arizona, they created a plan with something of interest for just about everyone. This scale model has now been recreated in full scale and remarkably close to the original plan. But Chermayoff says building this facility is a real tribute to the people and businesses here that supported it.
Finding it, many cities in this country would like to do it. Some can pull it off, get the money together. New Orleans just did recently. There are others that are doing it. In Philadelphia, they're building one across the river from Philadelphia. It's a tremendous public interest. Chattanooga's a great deal to be proud of.
So now, through all of the work, sweat, waiting, planning, and anticipation, it's here, with hopes it will add some $50 million or more to the local economy each year.